Libra, it's me, Stormy, and here's your annual horoscope for 2020. And Libra, what a year. Astrologically, we've got cool things going on. Saturn and Pluto conjuncting at the beginning of the year. Throughout the year, we've got Jupiter and Pluto conjuncting. We end the year with the great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn, plus six eclipses this year, and every planet that can retrograde is going to this year. So it is quite the year, Libra, and you have got some intense focus, especially in the first part of the year, on all things that have to do with your workplace or your home place, your public life versus your private life. Not to mention, we'll have Saturn taking a little jump into the energy of Aquarius in the beginning of the year. He'll retrograde and come out of that energy, but then he's going to make a solid tour in the energy of Aquarius, lighting up your fifth house. And I can tell you all about Saturn visiting your fifth house because I just finished a year of it. And so I will give you the tea. I will get you informed on everything going on. Now, first and foremost, right here at the beginning of the year, January 10th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in the energy of Cancer. Now, this is at 20 degrees. So this is at the tip top of your chart. This is going to bring your attention to things in your career or things in your public life, a public sector in some way, shape, or form. This lunar eclipse is our time where we're going to end something, acknowledge something, or make an adjustment. But this is an adjustment that's going to last for about 6 months down the road. So this is a pretty big shift that happens for you, even if it's quite subtle. Now, one of the things that I love about a lunar eclipse or any kind of moon energy is it kind of lifts the veil of something you couldn't see or something you couldn't quite get to, but it does bring a disruption, and the disruption is about kicking us on the path, right? Like getting us in the right alignment. But on January 12th, we've got Pluto and Saturn coming together. And when these two heavy hitters dance together, this is kind of a big deal. It only happens about every 34 years. And when it does, it creates this kind of slow evolutionary process. And this will be in your fourth house, home, family, real estate, property. And these are the kind of things when these energies come together where Pluto's trying to help you die off in Phoenix, right? You die off one way so that you can live in another. And Saturn is leveling you up, giving you more responsibility, more discipline, things like this. But this can impact things, especially in the 10th and 4th house, in your own personal economic life. It can bring a little bit of what perceives to be a hardship in some way, shape, or form. So could there be a challenge with where you're living and that's keeping you blocked from these changes you're trying to make at work? Is there something happening with your actual physical house that you're having to put a little bit more money or a little bit more effort into in some way, shape, or form? In the fourth house, I always think about parents and family and women in your life as well. So this could be a time where what you're experiencing is it feels like loss or it feels like a hardship in some way, shape, or form. But this is the thing about the Pluto-Saturn energy. What feels like the loss will be very quickly replaced by you being very prepared in this area. The universe never leaves a hole. It never leaves a hole. So whatever is shifting and changing here, just know it will be pretty quickly replaced by the benefits that are coming here as well. Not to mention, we do have Jupiter traveling around through this energy as well. So this is going to bring some expansion. I think whatever's happening, I can tell you, be prepared. Use the energy of Jupiter. Use your wisdom. If you don't know how to handle a situation that's coming up between work and home or your public life and your private life, seek wisdom, seek information, and that'll help you be prepared to move forward, especially for this first 6 months, okay? Mercury is going to retrograde 3 different times this year per usual. It'll be in February, June, and October, and I will cover those in the monthly videos and their own separate videos as well. But what you can do is go back into my 2019 Mercury retrograde in your element video, because we're going to see much of the same kind of trend happening with that Mercury energy. So make sure you check that out. It's in the playlist for sure, okay? March 22nd, we've got Saturn moving into the energy of Aquarius, but this is for a short time. It's just a little snick snack, a little sneak peek of what's going to be happening. When Saturn moves into a new area of your chart or moves into a new sign, it's going to bring an energy of needing to level up. So it can come with responsibility. It can feel a little bit heavy at that time. You just notice this area of your life as starting to have a little bit more impact. Now, Saturn in the energy of Aquarius for you lands in the fifth house. And like I said, I just am getting through with this particular transit. And what this can look like, though, is it brings a focus of children or your childhood as well. I did so much shedding of my own youth, even as an adult, childish ideas that I had that just wouldn't work to take me forward. Because it's also a beginning. This is an energy of a beginning, a conception of something brand new in your life, a new business, new children, adoption, any of these kinds of things, your own expression come to the table. But Saturn is going to level you up. And to do that, you've got to take on a fair amount of accountability. Other things you could see happening with this energy is that maybe your children are going to college or something's happening with your children that actually makes them quite expensive at this time. And yes, children are expensive, but it brings extra expense into your life, or it's extra time from you. It's extra self-sacrifice from you in different ways than it's been showing up before, but it certainly brings an area of maturity into your life around these things. Now, like I said, this is only going to be a short visit because Saturn's going to take some retrograde and get back into the energy of Capricorn. And it's almost like he backs up in there and says, did you take care of this area? And then when we get to December, Saturn will come forward again. So we'll talk about that in a minute. May 13th through June 25th, your ruling planet of Venus is going to retrograde in the energy of Gemini. Now, this is going to light up your ninth house space. Publishing, broadcasting, putting yourself out there in any way, shape, or form, teaching, higher education, anything in higher education, things that have to do with the law could be presenting themselves here. But I also think of the ninth house primarily as the house of faith and our beliefs and what I believe, my morals, my ethics, what drives me, my moral compass, right? So some of the things you could be doing in a retrograde is relooking at all of these areas, right? In your marketing, does it visually, is it beautiful? Is it diplomatic? Does it have a harmony to it? The energies of Venus. Do you like your marketing? Are you putting that book out there this year? Do you love that cover? What does the font look like? All of these things you could be reviewing in a very practical way. Also in the ninth house, if you have had a business relationship or a romantic relationship that has needed to be reviewed, and maybe it involves the law in some way, shape, or form, you could definitely be seeing yourself going back over one of these relationships from finances to romance as you're during this retrograde time, but certainly re-looking over all sorts of connections to how you are expanded out in the world will be on the agenda. Now, June 5th, we're gonna have a lunar eclipse in the energy of Sagittarius at 15 degrees. So this is already at that Venus retrograde time. We start to light up that ninth house. Now we're gonna have some lighting up of the third house, which these are your thinking houses, decision-making houses, how I communicate. So with this lunar eclipse happening here in your third house, one of the things you could be doing is re-looking over a contract, re-looking over your website, going back to a book. You could be ending something so that you can start something else, but it will certainly give you a nice action-packed amount of energy to do something with as we move through this third house, your siblings, your communications. Maybe this is a phenomenal time to begin studying something or putting out your own class even. This would be great for that. If you wanted to sell a house, buy a car, buying and selling are brilliant under this energy as well. Now, all throughout the year, we've got Jupiter and Pluto coming together three different times to give you some action-packed energy. It's like a focused, super, like, cappuccino shot to help you get things done. So in April, June, and November, Jupiter and Pluto are going to come into conjunction with each other. And for you, this will light up issues in the fourth house. Now, I tell you that at this point because something that may have happened is things are happening in this fourth house for you. Jupiter and Pluto come along together in a conjunction, and you're able to take a big leap forward, big action. You're really able to make some progress. It is focused. It is brilliant. It is a positive indicator that you have growth and you have motion in this particular area. So if you're looking to relocate so that you can work, if something's going on with a family member or something like that, look to these times to be taking action and making some really good decisions that will help you all year long. It is so focused. Don't miss out on that energy. All right, June 21st, we're going to have a solar eclipse at 0 degrees of Cancer, lighting up that 10th house, career, workplace, your public life. If you're retired, this still responds to your public life. What are you doing in your community? What is your gift you have to give to the world? What are you known for, Libra? This still applies whether you're working or not working, right? Now, on July 5th, we're going to have a lunar eclipse in the energy of Capricorn at 13 degrees, which puts us again in the fourth house. This is the last time we're going to see this Capricorn Cancer axis lit up. So we're going to move on here shortly from this career and family life, but right now there's still work to do. So with that solar eclipse, you could see new happenings, new beginnings coming to your career table or your public life kind of energy. And that again will last you about 6 months. And at the same time, that lunar eclipse could be ending something at home. If there have been transitions with the house, with family members or something like that, you've got a beginning that will bring an ending and vice versa, but it is all about progressing forward and you've got a nice 6 months to be able to interact and to work with that, okay? September 9th through November 13th, we've got Mars taking his retrograde in the energy of Aries, which is going to light up your seventh house because it's right across the street. Now, Mars is not entirely uncomfortable during this retrograde because he's at least in one of the signs that he rules. So this shouldn't be an terribly uncomfortable retrograde, but it is certainly a time to look back. Aries is the energy of identity, of the self. Of how I'm moving forward. Mars is the energy of action and energy. What am I putting my efforts into? What do I desire? We recommend that during a Mars retrograde, if you can avoid doing any surgeries or anything like that, that's a really good idea, as Mars and Aries are both the energies of war, of cutting. And when we go into surgery, the surgeon and the cutting that will happen both fall under this. But if you have to have surgery at this time, you do what you need to do. The universe has got your back, okay? But if you can avoid scheduling anything elective, we suggest that you do that. Now, for you in the seventh house, this is about relationships. How much effort are you putting into relationships, and are you getting a return on that investment that is going to supercharge, power you, and be Team Libra? Right? In your relationships, have you put no effort and energy into relationships? If you want a romantic relationship, you know, or you want a business relationship, have you kind of been resting on your laurels and you haven't really been doing your part to move that forward? In the desire area, what do you want in relationships? What are you willing to do to be in any kind of relationship that you would like to be in? The other thing I just keep thinking of, especially with that ninth house being so powerful with the Venus retrograde, is in your, if you have been in a position in your relationships, even if it's the relationship with you and your educational or your academic institution, if you feel like you're just fighting and fighting and fighting for things, Libra, maybe it's time to put your efforts into something else. Maybe do it a little bit differently, right? Could you be putting more action and energy into taking different actions, or to maybe doing it in a way that's maybe a little unconventional? Do you have your ego and your identity attached to something, and that's why you're fighting so hard for it, when really it's not the most productive use of your action? Now, if you are happy as can be in all of your relationships, from romance to business, this still gives you an opportunity to re-look over where your energy maybe needs a little bit of adjustment, where you want to go moving forward, that Mars's actions can take you as we come out of the retrograde. So it's a really, really kind of comfortable energy, but you're still going to need to look back at how you're doing what you're doing. November 30th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in Gemini at 8 degrees. This will light up the third house. Just after that, we've got a solar eclipse in Sagittarius at 23 degrees. Now we've jumped into this third, ninth house balance out of that 10-4 situation. So we've really got to have some focus here in shifting new teaching, new communications, new learning, new freedom from legal situations. Maybe you've entered into a new contract or negotiation. Let's say that you bought that house and maybe it's a little bit bigger, so you're expanded. Maybe you signed on to be that adjunct teacher. You know, not everything has to be big and huge. Maybe you've signed a new lease, right? Any of these things create a beautiful beginning for you as we arrive here in this November-December timeframe. Now, December 17th, Saturn's going to officially move back into the energy of Aquarius, so boom. Now this fifth house is lit up and you will begin to do the growing of fifth house work that Saturn brings into this area. I have no doubt you will have a technological or organizational piece that comes along with all of your fifth house learning, because Aquarius is the energy of do it different, but also connecting to organizations, technology, and things like that. So it could be that your children or your business or something like that needs to be connected in an organizational kind of way, but it's maybe very different than anything you've experienced before. I look forward to seeing how this lights up for you, so please keep me posted down below in the comment section. Now, this is going to be in place. Saturn in Aquarius in your fifth house is going to be here until 2023. So you've got some time to work on these energies. On the 20th, Jupiter moves into the energy of Aquarius. Again, fifth house focus. And on the 21st, Jupiter and Saturn come together in conjunction in the energy of Aquarius. Now, this is always a big deal astrologically, because when Jupiter and Saturn come together, they're called the rulers of the age. And as we move towards the age of Aquarius, we see that these two, which is structure, law, order, meets wisdom, meets advancement, meets expansion, right? And it's gonna start to take shape in our economic worlds, our political climate, religious and belief issues, of course, in our laws and medicine. All of these things will begin to be affected by these two coming together. For you, this will be in the fifth house. You will, in some way, shape, or form, see the advancement of this area of your life, but you're also coming into it with a fair amount of wisdom. It's almost as if you have a unique perspective that you can grow in this area. It hasn't been in this area for 29 years, so what you'll build here with these energies are things that you can stand on for the next 29 years. So I would just ask you, in this area, where have your beliefs changed? Where are you going to allow this energy to bring a little bit of calm to the chaos and the confusion that's maybe been in this area, whether it be romance and wanting to have a relationship or a relationship that went south, to business, to children? What are your new beliefs and ideas that are maybe very Aquarian, outside of the box, outside of your box, so they allow you to expand your thinking and your beliefs and your movement on this planet, Libra, from the hula hoop that you've just been living in? So it's a wonderful, wonderful energy. Now, I would also ask you to think back to 2012 to 2015. Uranus and Pluto were dancing together. What was changing for you? Because the changes were there. They were abundant. Many of them came from the societies that you live in, wherever you're at globally. The changes that came up for you then, now it's like you're better able to integrate those things and also find your place in the story of what's happening and unfolding in the world. So think back to that time, so that way you can kind of map out maybe where some of these are going to really express themselves for you as well. All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I look forward to walking with you every month and every week as we travel 2020, bringing you lots of teaching opportunities. And of course, if you would like a personal reading to know what 2020's got laid out for you, I look forward to working with you in that capacity as well. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you very soon. Bye.